In last lecture, we have started the new lesson, that is introduction to the acid and bases. Inside it, we seen the acid, those who are sour in taste, they are very strong. And then what happens if the strong acid burn the skins? Okay, after that we seen the bases. Bases are also strong and weak are there. Bases are bitter or the astringent in taste, and some indicators we seen, and I told you to learn this. The effect of change in color indicator when in acids and in the bases. So here this box I told you to learn it. Okay, after that we are starting the next part of our lesson. Okay, so here it is, the box. It is shown in this box inside. If you observe here, the name of some indicators are given. Name of some indicator. Indicator means what I told you, the substance which helps us to identify the given substance is a given substance is acidic or basic. Okay. Now, here some name of indicators are given. So first of all, litmus paper is given. Two types of litmus papers are there. I told you before only, the blue litmus paper and the red litmus paper. Here it is given. Okay, blue and red litmus papers are shown here. So this one is a red litmus paper and this is the blue litmus paper. Okay, so red and blue litmus paper. After that some more indicators are given here. Those are methyl orange, phenolphthalein and methyl red. These indicators are there. And we are going to see the change in color in the acids and bases, which this box is there. Okay, this box orange color indicators in the laboratory. That box information is given in the tabular form in front of you. So first of all, one by one we will see the effects of the indicators on the acid and bases. So first of all, litmus paper. Which litmus paper? Blue litmus paper. As I told you before only, in acid inside the blue litmus paper turns red. Acids inside blue litmus paper turns red, and in alkalis inside or bases inside, the blue litmus paper remains as it is, that is blue only. There is no change is seen on this paper. Okay, next, second litmus paper is a red litmus paper. As I told you that red litmus paper remains red only in the acids. Red litmus paper remains red in the acids, and that of the red litmus paper turns blue in the bases. Red litmus paper turn blue in the bases or in the alkalis. Third indicator is the methyl orange. Third indicator is the methyl orange. Here it is orange, and its color means methyl orange, its color is orange only. If you see here in the picture, this is methyl orange and its color is looking orange in the bottle. Okay, now this methyl orange is there, it is orange in color generally, and when we add this methyl orange into the acids, the acid turns pink in color, and when you are adding it to the bases or alkalis, the color of the solution changes to the yellow. And from that we said that if we are adding this methyl orange into a substance, and if the substance turns milk, then it is acidic in nature, and if it turns yellow, then it is basic or alkaline in the nature. Next is the phenolphthalein. Phenolphthalein is colorless. If you see this bottle, the solution is there inside it, and that colors of the solution is which? That is, it is colorless. Now this phenolphthalein is colorless indicator is there. And when you are adding this phenolphthalein in the acids, the color is not changing, it remains as it is. Means acid inside phenolphthalein, when we are adding it, the color is colorless, and that's why then we can say that the given solution is acidic in nature. But this only phenolphthalein, when we are adding into the alkalis, it turns pink in color. So when we are adding this phenolphthalein in solution and the solution turns the pink, then this given substance is a alkaline in nature. Lastly, methyl red. If you see here, the methyl red is shown here, and its color you can see here, it is red in color. Methyl red is red in color, means actually color of the indicator is the red. And when you are adding it to the acids, the solution turns red, then it is acidic in nature. And when we are adding to the base, and it shows the yellow color, means in substances inside, if you add, and if the substance color changes to yellow, then it is alkaline, and when it turns to red, then it is a base. So this is a change in color in the acids and bases of this different indicator. So without taking test, because you know that the strong acids are very dangerous, it burns the skin, okay, so we cannot take the test also, we cannot smell it also, because smell is also what happens, it is very dangerous to the human beings. If you open the lead of a acids like hydrofluoric acid, sulfuric acid, then also what happens, it shows the fumes are coming out of that bottle, and that fumes, if you are taking into your respiratory system, it is very dangerous. So without taking taste, without taking smell, we can identify that the given substance is acidic or the basic by using these indicators. Okay, clear? That's why these indicators are very important for important in the laboratory study. Next part is the domestic indicator. Domestic indicators means that we are using generally available to us. So domestic indicators on non-availability of laboratory indicators. Above this are the, these all are the laboratory indicators, means litmus papers, then methyl orange, phenolphthalein and the methyl red. These are the laboratory indicators. But sometimes what happens on non-availability of laboratory indicators, suppose sometimes we have to take a identify that given substance is acidic or basic without taking taste and the smell. So at that time some natural indicators are there that we can use for identification of the substances. So here it is given, the domestic indicators on non-availability of laboratory indicator. If laboratory indicators are not available, natural indicators can be made by using several domestic substances. Okay, some domestic substances are there, means which are available in our home, in our surrounding, those substances we can use as a domestic indicator. For example, I told you turmeric powder. Turmeric powder, when we are added to the base, what happens? It turns red in color. So that is the domestic indicator. You must have seen the yellow food stain. You must have seen the yellow food stain is there turning red after washing with soap. That yellow color is because of which? The turmeric powder. And washing powder is the base. Soap is the base, and base inside the turmeric powder, what happens, shows the indication of red color. So this color change is the result of chemical reaction between whom? That is turmeric powder and the alkaline material of soap. Here turmeric powder, turmeric acts as a an indicator, okay, and natural indicators can also be prepared from red cabbage. Here red cabbage we are getting in the market, radish, tomato, similarly from the hibiscus flower and rose flower. By using these substances we can make the indicators in the domestic. This from this, if we are making the indicators, these are the domestic indicators. Next, making of natural indicator. Now these are there, but how to make this natural indicator? Okay, so in our home also we can make these natural indicators, and the process is given here. First of all, hibiscus flower we have today, rose flowers, turmeric, red cabbage leaves, filter paper, that we have to take. After that, what we have to do? We have to do the following activity to prepare this, what? Papers. So here, rub the petals of hibiscus flower on the white filter paper. White filter papers are there, it is there in our lab also. So that hibiscus flower's petals we have to take out red color, and we have to rub it on the white filter paper, and this gives the hibiscus indicator paper. Isn't it easy? Yes, it is very easy. And the paper hour means that how above filter litmus papers are there, same way our one indicator paper is becoming ready like this paper. So we have to, what you have to use the that filter paper. On this filter paper, if you rub the hibiscus flower, then what happens, the hibiscus indicator paper is ready now. Similarly, rub the rose petals on white filter paper. Similarly, rub the rose petals on white filter paper, then the rose petal filter paper is ready. Cut the strips of this paper. It is rose indicator paper. Okay, the turmeric powder and little water in it. Turmeric powder we have to take, and we have to add a little bit water in it, and dip the filter paper on ordinary paper or ordinary paper in the turmeric water for some time. Just let it wet inside that turmeric powder solution, and then after drying, make the strips of that paper. Now the turmeric paper indicator is ready. Prepare the turmeric indicator paper. You can make it at home. Rose available in our home. Hibiscus flowers are available in our surrounding area. Afterwards, turmeric is available in our home only. Put leaves of the red cabbage. Red cabbage now in our area we are not getting. In small quantity of water and heat it. Okay. Once the solution of cabbage leaves cool down, that cabbage leaves are there, red cabbage leaves, we have to put into the water and we have to boil that, heat it, and after when it cools, dip the paper in it and dry it. And now the strip of dried paper cut, and then what happens, in this way we can prepare the red cabbage indicator paper. Okay, so this is the process given how to prepare the natural indicators papers, or the how the filter papers are there, litmus papers are there. Same way we can prepare our own paper for identification of the acids and the bases. Okay, now the next part is the put some drops of substances on the indicator paper and prepare the above method and write the effect of the following table. So this is the activity is there, and that we have to what do at home. So what we have to do here, put some drops of following substances, means lemon juice, lime water, okay, on an indicator paper and prepared by the above and mentioned, means in this way you have to prepare the papers. And after preparing this, you have to put which substances are present in our home. That substances we have to put the on it, and then we have to decide that what the change in color we have to notice, and then what happens, we have to write the is it acidic or is it basic. So here if you are taking lime juice, then lemon juice, what is its effect on turmeric paper? So today you have to do this. There is a no effect on this turmeric paper, and if it is there, so it is acidic in nature. Lime water means calcium hydroxide. When we put on this turmeric powder, it turns red, okay, and so it is a basic in nature. So all of you take some substances from your area and complete this activity, and you just tell me, isn't it means just identify it, isn't it acidic or is it basic. Okay, now take baking powder. What we have to do, we have to take the baking powder, add a little water to it, and add this solution onto the lime juice, okay, vinegar, orange juice, apple juice, etc., and note the findings. So here what they told you, add a so first of all baking powder we have to take, otherwise soda which your mother is using for preparing pakoda is otherwise bhaji, that you have to take, and add the water inside it, and add this solution to the lime juice, vinegar, orange juice, apple juice. So if you see here that baking soda, on this baking soda when we are pouring, if that you seen that Eno's advertise how the effervescence are coming, in that way when the lime juice we are pouring on the baking soda, it shows the effervescence means it shows the bubbles are coming, and that bubbles, from the bubbles the gas is evolving and bubbles are breaking. If you just do this activity at your home, you will see what is happening. What do you observe? The addition of baking soda solution on the fruit juice. So whether bubbles form or effervescence come out from the fruit juice, okay, bubbles or effervescence are coming. From the above first activity, we come to know that turmeric indicator paper turns a red yellow color in certain solution. okay, red or yellow color in the some solution, certain solution. Similarly, addition of baking soda solution in the acidic solution bubbles come out, the effervescence are produced. Means when the baking soda we are adding to the juices, and if it shows the effervescence, then that juices means the fruits which we are taking, if shows the effervescence, lime juice, vinegar juice, orange juice or apple juice, they are acidic in nature. Okay, and turmeric powder turns red, then they are bases. So from this simple experiment we can say that the given substance is a acidic or it is alkaline in nature. Okay, so till that all of you studied, and today's activities are given here. No, you just do it at home. The substances are available in your home, and just write your observation and understand how to identify the acids and the bases from this activity. So today we will stop here only. Okay, thank you, have a good day, and complete the work also.